going to fake it. I'm going to go out on a limb and say that you don't like that call on the opening drive of the game.
It's a very strong limb that you're out on right now. Okay, and look, the game between college and the NFL continues to creep closer, but that is truly a college play, not an NFL play. Because you'd snap the ball from the 3-yard line there, whether it's going for one or going for two. So it makes sense to try it that way to maybe fake it. In this case, from the 15, makes zero sense.
And now your lead's just 6-0 instead of 7-0. Tagovailoa and the Dolphins come up first and 10 at their 25-yard line. They'll run for the first time here with Matt Breida. He'll have a first down past the 40. Through an opening, and there he goes. And all the way in for a Miami touchdown. Matt Breida, 75 yards. And the Dolphins have tied it. Now they can take the lead with the extra point. I don't think you can get any more efficient or tidy, whatever word you want to use, than that, man. One play, 75 yards, end zone.
Yeah, efficient, tidy, excellent words. How about explosive? 75 yards, one play. That means everyone handled their assignment, doesn't it? It doesn't just mean that the defense broke down. They really executed the way that was drawn up on the whiteboard. Big time play, big time result.
The Steelers take over first and 10. At their own 27-yard line.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. Dobbs looking to throw on first down. Flushed out right. Space to maneuver at the 40. Completing it to the right side, Johnson. And he'll finally be taken down just shy of midfield. A good pickup there, a 22. Stepping up, he's going to keep it. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down.
For a Pittsburgh Steeler. First and 10 at the 40-yard line.
Throwing here, Dobbs. And the Dolphins rush gets home. Down he goes. Christian Wilkins just would not be denied. That's a loss of 7. Now following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17. The throw down the field, caught by his running back. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins' 29-yard line. The Steelers able to pick up 18 yards there. On first and 10, Dobbs. That's complete. It's Anthony McFarland. And he's in. Touchdown, Steelers. Anthony McFarland, 29 yards. And the Steelers are going to retake the lead. Mike Tomlin says, let's go ahead and go for two. Back to throw, Dobbs. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Eric Rowe.
It's interesting that when it comes to two-point conversions, even heavy run teams tend to throw the ball in these situations. In this case, this one was intercepted.
Yeah, they weren't fooled. They were ready for the pass, picked it off. Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback.
25-yard line.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And they hit the home run last drive. One play on the ground all the way to the house. Now the defense, maybe they're expecting a run here.
Partner, I love your description, because when we talk about hitting the home run, we're usually thinking about a passing play, aren't we? Something in the air, deep ball. But how about them just taking it? Big time jaunt. Now if you're coming back out, now they've established this run game, the play action pass could very well be open.
Tagovailoa to throw on second down here. That'll be complete to Breida. And he'll maybe get back to the line of scrimmage, but no more than that.
And that's when it's fun to play defense. When you're able to diagnose a play right from the beginning, get all your guys to the football and spill the play, that's when you have a lot of fun playing on that side of the ball.
Out of the gun on third down, here's Tua. He's going to loft one deep left side. This is caught at the 20. The way in for a Miami touchdown.
Complete.
Jakeem Grant, 70 yards. And the Dolphins are once again going to retake the lead. And the lead is now 2.
The kick is good. Makes the score Dolphins 14, Steelers 12. Jason Sanders to kick off for Miami.
Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. Here comes Johnson on the return. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20.
The Steelers take over first and 10 at their own 18-yard line.
The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. On the run, here's Anthony McFarland. And he'll find some space up to about the 25. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3. Running with McFarland. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
Pittsburgh Steeler. First and 10 at the 29-yard line.
And now some motion before the snap. And this will be our first penalty of the night's proceedings. Full start, backs him up 5, 1st and 15. Out of the gun, Dobbs. He'll get this one to McFarland out of the backfield. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. They'll get the penalty yardage back, plus 5 more as they get it to 2nd and 5.
At the 34-yard line.
Under pressure, and he'll go down. They'll sack him on what ought to be the final play of this first quarter. Second quarter action from Pittsburgh. It is the Steelers in control of the football. Second quarter action from Pittsburgh. It is the Steelers in control of the football. They're facing a tough spot, 3rd and 8 here to start things out.
As his old brain remembers, when I see 5 wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
So here we go. The offense is going to stay out there. They're going for it on 4th and 8.
9:55.
They'll try and throw for it here. Looking for Johnson, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Noah Igbinoghene. And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line.
At their own 39-yard line.
The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. 2 drives, 2 touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, 2nd and 2.
It's a gain of 8. Brings up 2nd and 2 at the 47-yard line.
Tua wants to throw it on 2nd down. He's going to float this one deep right side. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be 3rd down.
You could tell they wanted to get that ball downfield, but they had nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it off to the running back. That one ended up incomplete.
Ballooning the pressure right. They'll set up a screen for Breida. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 41. Call it a loss of six on the play. And it'll be fourth down. Here we go on fourth down with Tua. And the Steeler pressure too much here. He's going to go down. Cameron Hayward and the Steelers, they're going to take over an excellent field position. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Into double coverage and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 13. That's sort of a second quarter to forget for him. Now two picks in this frame.
Almost as if the first one that he threw, he couldn't shake, couldn't get it out of his head. He ends up throwing a second one as a result.
Compounds the mistake a little bit.
Yeah, you got to be able to forget, compartmentalize, whatever you want to call it, and move on. He hasn't been able to do so here in the second.
And he'll go down right on the edge of the red zone following a pickup of about seven or eight. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and three.
Second and three at the 20-yard line.
Out of the shotgun, Breida. And he's able to get up here to the 26.
Breida, the ball carrier. He was brought down at the 26. A gain of seven. First down, Dolphins.
Once again, they run with Breida on first down. A beautiful spin and room to run. And they're able to get this one across the 35.
He's brought down.
A Miami first down, that one going for a gain of 11. We've seen him break off a big run already in this game, and for a second, that one looked like it might be another.
Yeah, I think that any defense would say, look, we can't let him get to the second level, because sometimes you'll break off a big run on his own, but oftentimes you get additional blocking at the second level, which gets you deeper into the secondary.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down.
First down.
Now they'll throw with Tagovailoa. He's going to float this over the middle deep. And this is going to be intercepted. Joe Hayden, the veteran, with a pick. Defensively that time, they were in zone coverage. As a rookie QB, what lesson can you learn there?
Well, understand this. You saw zone in college, and the defensive backs reacted, but they don't react like they do on this level. So when they're in zone and they see the ball coming to them, they'll react at least a half a second faster. You've got to know where you want to go with the ball and be decisive with it. Otherwise, the end result can be something you don't like.
He'll get five out of the scramble. It's second down. Dancing to his left. A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, first down. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off, Byron Jones. So that is three interceptions now in this first half, and you hate to ask the question, but let's be honest, we're thinking about it. Do you need to go in a different direction next series?
Potentially. We know that he's probably not going to be on the Pro Bowl ballot. That's not really his stature here, but he has been their starting quarterback for this game. So they've got to weigh things about who's behind him. Do they think he can snap it back into gear? Maybe change up the play calling to help him out a little bit.
And that'll hurt the average a bit, as this time they're able to get him behind the line.
The tackle made back at the 39-yard line.
We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll pay a visit to Jonathan Coachman. He's in Orlando, and he'll have our EA Sports halftime report. On second down, Tua. He'll get this into the hands of Breida.
Bring it!
And all the way in for a Miami touchdown. Matt Breida, he scored on the ground and through the air. And the Dolphins strike quickly here for 6 points.